Chief Lonwick, I had a once-in-a-lifetime chance to be able to inspire that same feeling in boys and girls that I've helped talk to at charity events, schools, after-school programs, and really besides inspiring Illini fans to cheer for our team to victory, that to me was really what I've taken pleasure in the most. And so if a young boy or girl would ever come to me and say that going away from seeing Chief Lonwick was able to motivate them to go open up a book, go online, research about Native Americans, then I consider that a job well done for me. And let me clarify one thing about the dance of Chief Lonwick. It has no religious significance whatsoever. It's a fancy dance. The fancy dance is used for entertainment purposes. The only difference, it used different aspects of the traditional dancing patterns that fit in with the 3-in-1 music, which is actually even older than the Chief tradition itself. The Chief portrayers have had a long-standing relationship with the Lakota Sioux, and the past regalia, in fact, the Chief wore was given from Lakota Sioux spiritual leader Frank Fuglescrow. The past regalia, the Chief, and I can say actually with pleasure that regalia, with help from former Lonwick portrayers, was returned to the Oglala Lakota College in South Dakota, which is actually on display to tribute to such a great man. The NCAA called the Chief tradition hostile and abusive. Now, I don't see any hostility in the Chief performance. The Chief doesn't have a tomahawk. He isn't intimidating by whooping and hollering on a horse as he drives a spear into the ground. Yet, that is still allowed, but Chief Lonwick isn't. The Chief shows a beautiful and separate side of Native culture that really isn't portrayed in the everyday media, one that's not hostile or abusive, but one that is not always portrayed accurately. The first portrayer, Lester Lutwiler, simply wanted to bring to the Illini fans and the rest of the country a taste of Native culture, a culture that was here long before us, one that should not be forgotten, because it's still alive and well, and Students for Chief Lonwick has been helping keep it that way. For the past year, Students for Chief have been completing a service project to help with the annual rebuild of the Grand Kickapoo Village in Leroy, Illinois, in time for their annual intertribal powwow, held on June 5th and 6th. This is a huge, huge event for us. It's very local. This is where Indian nations from all over the country will be competing in dances, selling art, and crafts. They're basically opening the doors to the rest of us in order to share their culture with us. So this is a wonderful opportunity to be able to see different styles of dress, grass dances, fancy dancing. If you have any questions, we actually have bookmarks. If you really want to attend this, I strongly, strongly encourage you. I think Jerry over here, the guy in the red, he has bookmarks. So if you guys are interested in seeing this at all, please come forth. The Chief was loved and cherished for over 4 generations. That's 80 years of a symbol of pride and a symbol of pride for the Illini fans. As a former athlete at the university, I actually walked onto the track team my freshman year. I believe that there is no better symbol that represents all that an athlete embodies. Just the power, the strength, the boldness, and the grace that the Chief carries in a single performance is something that our athletes appreciate and can look forward to as inspiration in competition. The Chief Lonwick was loved and cherished by hundreds of thousands of Illini and even Big Ten fans for every football, basketball, volleyball season. The love he had from all of the country was incomparable. Yet the NCAA and the former administrators wanted to simply sweep all of that under the rug. But we will not let that happen. The Emil Joneses, the Whites, and the Epleys out there underestimated just how much we love Chief Lonwick. We love him enough to fill Assembly Hall twice. Twice, even without an athletic event going on, we were able to pack hundreds of Illini fans into the stadium. And as Samantha Oer says, my friend and board member of the Students for Chief will explain in great detail a little bit later, the current administration is doing things that they really shouldn't be. Things that you would think they would have learned from others' past mistakes by now. So let me just say this. Students for Chief held the next dance in Assembly Hall this past fall. The administration did everything possible to try to make our event as insignificant as possible. And we found evidence of administrators conspiring to diminish the turnout of a student-registered organization event. Now, how is it that people are hired and paid to represent the student body get away with doing the exact opposite? They allowed us to hold the event, yes, but what should be noted is that they purposefully gave us a time slot that would assure the smallest attendance possible. If you read the letters up on studentsforchief.com, you'll be able to read them yourself. They're all there. You can make up your mind for yourself. We requested days of where there would also be a football game, With no Assembly Hall scheduling conflicts and plenty of time for security to be able to handle the fans' transition from Memorial Stadium to Assembly Hall, yet they did not give us those dates. And the consequences was that we did not raise enough money, that would have gone to yet another Native American scholarship. For your information, we've given out two in as many years. And so the Next Dance is really what helps make those possible. So thank you, administration, for not allowing us to send another check out to a deserving student. So what we all need to realize is that we deserve better from the people up there, and that Chief Lonick is not dead, he's just on vacation. Thank you so much.